Let me ask you a question. Have you ever done something that you weren't so proud of? And if so, how did that make you feel? Did it haunt your thoughts and twist your dreams? Even with the best intentions, things still fall apart, unraveling to its very core, while destroying the foundation from which you built your lies on. Secrets. They will eat you alive. One by one, they are all found out, and each person affected more than the next with deadly ramification, turning friends into suspects. Secrets. Each life changed forever, and they will never be the same. Where each chip fell was nobody's game. Alliances formed and new rivalries began. You see, this chapter is still writing itself out as I speak, ravaging the hearts of those you promised to keep. Secrets. What will be the outcome of yours?
Hi. Derek. Something you want to tell me?
Yeah, come here, please. I'm glad you guys hit the phone.
So, what did you call me here for?
I have that shirt that you gave me a long time ago. I was going to return it to you.
That's it.
And I also wanted to talk to you.
Okay.
Come sit on the couch.
Yes, Cheryl. Is my cat suit ready? For the masquerade ball, girl. No, it's all night. Yes, I have my mask already.
No, I just arrived at work. Yeah, I'll be here all day. I have a lot to do.
Sure. Yeah. Thank you. You look nice. Nice looking suit, is it new?
No, this old thing. I get out the closet, I just... Yeah.
Want a drink or something?
No, it's too early.
Oh, you're turning down a drink? This is new.
Yeah. I need to have a sober mind so we can talk about what went on. So new drinks for me.
Well, look, I'm just still in shock about even going through that with you. And, like, never had an argument before.
I mean, but Derek, like, the shit that you said, like, that was some hurtful shit.
Okay, but you said some pretty low shit to me, too. Like, you said I was only good for sex. Come on, man. Really?
Okay, but you said I was the gel and don't drop the soap and all this other shit. I mean, that was uncalled for.
I was just really in my feelings, so... Look. At the end of the day, I apologize. I did hit the low bell, and you are my friend. So I want to make that clear.
I mean, I apologize too. I mean, I can see where you were coming from and how you reacted, but still, like, I feel like you was choosing Rob over me. Like, I've been your best friend since forever.
And you have every right to feel that way. I mean, at the end of the day, I was wrong, and I'm kind of looking back. You know I'm emotional. But she would really let me have it.
I mean, that makes two of us.
No, you took me back. I haven't seen you talk like that in a while.
I haven't had it talk like that in a while. And I just felt like all the stuff that I was going through and going to Rob's job and going here and there. And then it kind of just blew up in my face. And I was just like, well, damn, like, whose side is he on? Rob's? What?
Look, I got all of that from you. I learned from the master.
I mean... Yeah, okay. I can see that, but you were letting me hold it, though. Like, no shade. I was kind of gagging a little bit.
So where do we go from here?
I mean, how about that joint?
Yeah, let me get some water. Okay. Kitchen?
Yeah.
Well, good morning. You're late.
What the hell are you doing in my office?
Come on, we have some business to tend to. Have a seat.
Get your dinky feet off of my desk. This is that dirty studio you're used to working out of.
From the looks of this tiny place, it sure looks like it. Did Dad downsize your position or something?
No, my office is being renovated. And why am I explaining myself to you? You don't even work here.
Well, maybe I should be working here.
Oh, really? The board members will laugh in your face.
Are you so sure about that?
Oh, I'm sure.
Well, I got a little bored while I was waiting for you to show up. And I did a little reading.
Give me those.
Not so fast, sis. You know you really shouldn't leave things lying around that you don't want seen.
Really? They weren't lying around. You went through my stuff. It's called trespassing. And I could have you thrown out.
Oh, here you go with this thrown out. But before you go and do that, I got one question for you.
What is that, Jabril?
What would the board think about you double dealing behind their backs?
What are you talking about?
These papers. I mean, it's all here. You've been quite the little snake, haven't you?
Give me those damn papers.
But the thing is, like, you're a big emotional fucking basket case, though. Like, I guess that's why we're best friends, because I don't know. Like,
oh, thanks. Such a compliment.
I mean, I'm just being honest. Like, who the hell else is going to be honest with you, though? Like,
And when Fallon sends you to jail, I'll make sure to bail you out.
Thank you so much. But that's the thing. Can you imagine me in jail, though? Like, this bitch set me up behind bars, like, for the next fucking 5 to 10 years of my motherfucking life, like.
First of all, that whole image is a mess. And just imagine you in a big-ass orange short jumpsuit.
I kind of like orange a little bit. I mean, not a fucking jumpsuit, though. Like,
right.
Hell no. But, like, so what's been going on with you since we haven't talked in the last couple of days?
I went up to Rob's shop.
Okay, and what was that given?
Let's just say I made a little bit of a scene.
That, was you throwing glasses and shit?
Nah, not that guy. See, that's ratchet. But I did bring up the whole thing, man.
And what did he say?
He said it was just a joke, but...
Oh, he was joking. No, he's fucking sick. That's the thing. Like, I don't even see what the hell you see in him. Like, it... Honestly, it has to be the fucking B, because that boy is a lowlife. Like, he, like I said, he's a neighborhood hoe. Like,
I think it's more than that, though, to be honest with you.
Wait, what the hell do you mean? Like, whoa, wait. Please don't tell me that you, like, in love or feelings, or you more than like this little boy or something.
I do like him. I have a little bit of feelings. I know, I feel bad about it myself.
Okay. Like, but what makes you like him though? Like, he's crusty. Really? Like, he's kissed me. Like, so we can't even really be in the same room with each other. Like, I don't get it.
I mean, yeah, it's the sex is good, and we actually have really good chemistry. Mm-hmm. I can't even, like, deny it anymore. And, I don't know. I can't stop thinking about him.
So what do you think about besides the fucking bed, though? Like, I don't understand. What else does he make you think about besides being erect?
I can't put my finger on this. I even called him.
Can't put your finger on it, but you can put your finger in it, basically.
Pretty much. He's actually on his way here.
Okay, I'm fucking leaving. All right.
No, we have a little bit longer before he actually gets here.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's my fucking cue to go. What are you going to be here for, though? That's what I want to do. Like, why would you invite him over for?
I want to talk to him about our feelings. Just to see what he says, to see if it's not one-sided, and to see if he's actually genuine.
But that's the thing I'm saying, though. What if it's just one-sided? What if he's just doing this for sex, or some kind of greed, or some kind of fucking sabotage or something? That's what I don't get.
We'll find out, won't we?
Yeah, we'll find out. I want to hear about this one.
Where are your manners? You know what? Before you take the liberty and start
destroying evidence. I already took some candids on my phone. We're good.
So trespassing and larceny. You want to add something else to your case?
Let's agree on this. The only person that's going to be carted off is you. I read everything, man.
The lies you tell.
You know what? I know greed runs deep in this family, but I never thought that you would cheat the company.
Jamarill, what exactly are you accusing me of?
Come on now. You've been inflating the stock prices, double and triple in their worth. Where exactly is all this extra money going?
What the hell are you talking about?
Well, I'm about to go because I don't want to intrude, so I'm going to talk to you later.
You're not. He's actually coming a little earlier than I thought he was.
I guess. Well, let me know how it is. Text me, call me something.
I will. Actually, might see her. See. Hi.
Brian, we got your ass. Brainy and Monica editions. I'm gonna see you, okay? And watch where the fuck you going?
I'm on my way, Bradley. Yeah.
Fake ass Idris album. I'll see you later.
Bye.
Use protection. Text me.
Bye.
Good old-fashioned corporate fraud. You know, I thought you was a little bit smarter than that.
You wouldn't dare run your mouth.
You think after that little stunt you pulled with Robert the other night? Try me, Fallon.
So, you're willing to blow the whistle on this company? Mm. If I go down, Dad goes down. And if Dad goes down, this entire company goes down. And then you'll never get your money.
You know what? I wonder what the Securities and Exchange Commission would think about this revelation, this news.
Well, I see you in a better mood than the last time I saw you.
Yeah, about that. Let's forget that ever even happened.
Well, in order for that to happen, you have to do something for me.
Does everything you say have to have a sexual undertone?
No, it doesn't.
Look, I pretty much know your MO by now, and I mean, we have great sex, but at this point, I feel like we have something better now. We have great chemistry.
Yeah, you right.
Oh, so you agree?
Yeah, I mean, we both didn't set out for this to happen. It just did.
I mean, in the beginning, we were both using each other because we couldn't get what we both wanted. And who we wanted.
Yeah. So do you still love your bro?
Kinda. You still love Brandon?
Yeah, I do.
What's the point, man? I mean, where is this going to go?
Obviously, there's something between us. I know you can't deny that. I dare you.
Okay, Jabril. I'm going to play your little game. What exactly do you want from me?
The same thing I've always wanted since the first time I stepped in your door. I want my money.
You'll get your money. Now get out.
24 hours. Make it happen. Please.
I will. It wasn't even worth the money Dad paid for you.
What did you just say?
I didn't say anything. Please go.
No. What did you just say? It sounded like you said Dad paid for me.
You want the truth?
Fallon, stop playing with me. What are you talking about?
Dad bought you because he could.
Look, I hated myself in the beginning for even feeling this way. But I just can't deny it anymore.
So, what do you recommend we do?
I don't know. Take it slow.
How slow?
I don't even know how to take it slow with you. Such a fucking player, so.
I'm not as bad as you think. I just don't front like every other guy. I'm grown. So I do what I want with whom I want.
What? I'm still the same guy you met outside the booty bar. You know me.
And I know I can't trust you.
Well, considering the circumstances, I agree.
Look, I just want my next relationship to be with somebody that I can trust in the beginning, you know?
I've been straight up with you ever since I met you.
Have you?
I have.
Let me close this door. So here's your truth. When my mother found out that your mother was pregnant, she fired her. It wasn't until 9 months later your mother come back to our doorstep with you in her arms, begging for money.
So she wasn't there to give me up?
No, she was there for money. She wanted money like they all do. But my dad wouldn't give her one red nickel unless she gave him full custody.
What?
See, your mother tried to fight for you. But my father and my evil mother wore her down. She didn't have any family, and all she knew was the stripper pole. That doesn't have benefits. So what happens? She took a check, just like my mother did, and gave you to us.
This is some sick joke.
No joke, Jabril. See, what you don't understand is, our father didn't think that your mother should be raising a Davenport heir. So he took everything she had away from her.
So this whole time, my life has been this like one big lie.
This may sound really, really cruel, but you would not have had the life that you had if your mother would have raised you. It's just unfortunate for people like her.
So all this time, she actually wanted.
She couldn't raise you if she wanted to. There's no car seats and baby seats and no strip clubs.
You know what, Fallon? It's people like you and Dad that makes me wish I was born into another fucking family.
Really?
Speaking of trust, there's something I have to tell you.
What did you do this time?
Not me. Not me. This is about your bro.
I don't want to hear about it. Don't bring up his name in my house, please.
You sure you don't want to hear about it?
I'm very sure I don't want to hear about it.
Okay, I'll leave it alone.
Yeah. But I want tonight to be about you and me. It's a masquerade ball tonight, and I want you to be my date.
I never heard of this ball. My boss mentioned it to me. I'll go.
So you're okay with being about me and you tonight?
Yes, I am. Are you?
Yeah, I'm gonna prove it to you.
I'll prove it.
You know what, Fal? Cannot work it.
Your mother thought the same thing about you.
You think it's a fucking game?
Are you sure that I'm more than just sex to you?
Yeah. Dirk, you mean a lot to me. You're not just some dumb kid. I see that now.
Thank you, because
I'm really starting to see another side of you. I mean, once you take away the ego and the flirtatious manner, it's something good there.
Not too many people see this side of me.
And why is that? Why do you have an issue showing your caring side?
Because it never benefited me in the past.
So, you'd rather people think that you're a whore versus being a good guy?
Yeah.
That makes no sense.
I don't care about what people think of me. I stopped caring a while ago.
Secretly, that is a lie, because we all care what people think about us. Alone.
No, no. I've been this way for a very long time.
So your whole life?
Can we talk about this another time?
No, why can't we just talk about it now? If we just want to start whatever this is for something good, let's be honest from the beginning. Let's
another time.
I want to talk about it now.
I mean, Derek, watch out.
Prove to me that you are different.
Look, we were having a good time. Now you want to mess it up, bringing up old stuff.
Security, the man that just left out of here in the black suit, run the cameras back. He is no longer welcomed in this building. He is not to come in under any circumstances. Thank you.
Did I interrupt something? Because I can come in.
What? Issue. Come in. Come in.
Hello?
Now I hope you have some good news for me, because I am not in the mood for your shenanigans today. Not today.
I can tell.
Excuse me?
I'm just making an observation. Calm down. Shit.
I didn't know your little pea brain was capable of doing such a thing. Have a seat.
And that hell no, I was saying.
Suit yourself. Do you have what I asked for?
Of course, Your Highness. Two copies of the money transfers you asked for.
Thank you. All right. Did Clint put up a fight?
Now you know me, Clint don't fight. That's you.
Did you promise him you'd bend over when you got home?
Well, you lied to know Cruella.
No, I really...
But he gave me the money without any questions.
Okay, good. But what I really want to know is what kind of bag is that?
Oh, I got it from New York. What kind of bag is that?
Reed.
They still wearing canvas?
Me? I just asked a simple question. What's really the problem?
No problem. I'm good.
Then why are you acting so weird all of a sudden?
Derek, I'm fine.
All I want to know is why you feel comfortable being called a hoe. You gonna answer me?
Do you really want to know why I feel comfortable with it?
Yes.
Because I used to be an escort.
Oh.
You happy now?
I...
What? You feel differently about me now?
No, I'm not saying that.
You did. You're just like everybody else. I'm gonna treat you different just because, you know, it's an escort.
It's just such a shame that my husband's affection for you is going to cost him his freedom.
Now, Fallon, you know karma's a bitch, so you better watch your damn back.
Is that true? You better thank your lucky stars I didn't throw your little ass in jail with him.
Okay, thank you so much. How do I repay you?
Honey, I gave you life.
Now you sound like God. Okay.
I'm the closest thing to God.
Are you sure about that?
Quite sure.
You know what, Fallon? You're just a bit of big scorn. That's your issue.
And you know what, Ashton? Thanks to me, you could gallivant around here in them tacky-ass garments that clash with anything that's tasteful.
But the thing is, you gave me no choice, from the stalking, to the fucking following me, to all these bullshit ass meetings. You gave me no fucking choice. You brought me into this.
Listen, like God, your life is in my hands.
Oh, so you comparing yourself to God now?
When it comes to you, I'm the closest thing to it.
You think so?
I know so. Last time I checked, I was.
Sweetie, you don't realize that I got a lot of information on you too. So just keep this shit cute from now on. I heard that little conversation you had before I walked in.
See, the business that you run is crap. You wouldn't understand that was a business meeting. You don't know what the hell you're talking about.
My business? Your husband is funding my business. And that's the part that you can't take.
I have proof. You want to be sitting in jail right next to him? Oh, wait a minute. You might feel like you're home now, wouldn't you?
I'm going to let you know one thing. If you take me to jail, we all going down. Remember that.
We all going down, Ashton.
Of course.
Please.
I'm going to tell Clint, anybody else that will listen to all this bullshit you were just talking.
What makes you think I will let you get to Clint before having you locked up, or that he'd believe anything that you say?
Baby, Clint loves me. That's the issue.
You think you're the only infidelity issue that he's had? You really that stupid? You are.
You know what, Fallon? You might have had the fucking ring, but you never had the marriage.
Get out.
I'm not going nowhere.
Get out of my office. Get out of my...
Why? Because I had no choice. I did some things I'm not proud of.
Like what? You can tell me anything. This stays between you and me.
You sure about that? You may not like what you hear.
I'm very serious.
Well, it all started when my mom died. I had to go live with my aunt. It's about 12. I went from a happy home to hell in a matter of days.
What happened?
Well, my aunt only took me in because she wanted the checks from the state. She didn't give a fuck about me. She sold drugs at her house, had all type of crazy people in and out.
Were you molested?
Went right into that, huh?
Sorry.
I was molested.
Who molested you?
My aunt.
Your aunt? Your fucking mom's sister?
I had no choice. She told me, in order to live under her roof, I had to earn my keeps by any means necessary.
That's sick.
So, I had to zone out. In order to get the job done, I had to put myself in a place where I just felt comfortable. And as I got older, she sold me off to her friends. But that's when I decided to run away. I was about 16.
But where would you even go? I mean, I'm sure you have other family, but...
Mm-mm. I didn't trust anybody else. I didn't know where to go, so... I lived on the streets. And that's when I became an escort.
So, how long were you on the streets?
For about 2 years. Till I met this man named Calvin. He was the only person that cared about me and didn't want anything in return.
And who was Calvin, and did you tell him about it?
Calvin was my mentor. And eventually, but his main concern was getting me off the streets and back into school. That's when I met Brandon.
Well, I would never ever wish this on anybody. I'm sorry this happened to you.
Listen, I don't expect anybody to feel sorry for me. I had a rough life, but I made it through.
Have you ever talked to anybody about this?
Like a doctor?
Yeah, I think it would be a good idea.
I'm not talking to no damn shrink.
I think it would be a good idea. You need to talk to somebody.
What, you think I'm crazy?
I'm not saying you're crazy.
What are you saying?
I just think that there's nothing wrong with going to a doctor to seek help.
Oh, yeah.
coming from you. You fainted the other day and didn't even want to see the doctor.
Look, go to the doctor. I think you need to talk to somebody.
Listen, for what? Sleeping around on people?
I'm not saying that. Why are you being such a jerk right
now? I'm not being a jerk.
I just want you to be in good hands, and I want you to seek help. I'm looking out for your best and well-being.
Listen, I know you mean well, but I've been this way for a long time, and I'm not changing for nobody.
Stop it, Miss Davenport. Stop it.
Cop!
Stop it.
Call the police! Call the police!
Leave my shit!
Get out of my fucking office! My fucking
you
shit!
You lose, Valerie!
Get out!
You lose!
Get out!
Do you want me to call the police?
Yes!
I'm just trying to help you.
No, thank you. Remember what you said? I'm poison, right?
Wait! Are we at least still on for the date tonight?
I think about it.
Babe, where you at?
I'm about to go see Brandon, Jesus. Where you at?
No, I'm just going playing cards.
All right, well, I'm going to call you back in a second. Let me go talk to him. I'm going to call you when I get home.
But aren't you the die for?
Excuse me?
It's me, dog.
Oh my God!
Yeah,
I don't like somebody walking up behind me. How are you?
Apologies, you look pretty fabulous today.
You're putting up well yourself.
Yeah, I want to try to establish myself as a legitimate businessman.
You come to the right venue. What ask me?
There's some big money in this place right now, and I want my hands up from you.
Okay. Is there someone we can go and talk? I need to talk to you about something off the
restaurant.
Hi. I have a little thorn in my side by the name of Ashton Banks.
Oh. Okay. Yeah. Sure. So, come on. Can you check me?
Did you get my pepperoni pizza?
Sausage.
That was good. I got some wine.
Thank you. We'll get some plates, please.
Oh, good. I'm sorry, man.
And some cups.
So, Pam, what do you want to do with this Ashton Banks fella?
Well, for starters, that's the one that's fucking Clint.
You want to make him disappear?
No, Victor. I want you to grab him up and put some fear in his ass. That little queen is trying my patience.
What happened?
Well, for starters, I gave him the choice of freedom and jail, and he laughed in my face.
Interesting. Well, what's in it for me?
What do you want?
So I don't want any money, but I don't know. I want something that I haven't had before.
What you want, Victor?
I want a percentage of Davenport Peak Towers.
My towers in Atlantic City? That's risky. And given your line of work, how would that even suffice?
I'm a silent partner. You turn a blind eye, let me invest some of my foreign money.
Oh, I don't know, Victor. I don't know. That's very, very risky.
Trust me. It's perfectly fine, honey. Don't worry your pretty little face about it. You cannot track that money back to me, I assure you.
I don't know. When it comes to my businesses, I'm very careful. That's very risky.
Well, how bad do you want Ashton in your life?
Like yesterday. I got a funny little suspicion he's going to start running his mouth, and that I cannot have.
Well, what do you say, Fallon? Do we have a deal?
I've known you for years, and I do trust you, so... Yeah, we have a deal.
All right. I'll have my boys take care of him.
But don't have them take care of him tonight. Let them grab him tomorrow morning.
Okay.
Clint comes home soon, and I don't want anything to seem suspicious.
Alright, that sounds good. So come on, let's get this party started. Let's get a drink.
Yeah, because I need one.
So what do I owe the pleasure of this meetup, Brandon?
I just want to catch up.
Catch up on what?
Everything. There was a lot going on the last time I was around. I don't know what I walked into.
I mean, no. That damn Kiko is a mess. Like, she needs to worry about getting some clients in that empty-ass chair of hers. Trying to come for me like that.
Come on, Mason. When you feel the type of way if somebody came into your job choking you out?
I mean, yes, but her grievances were her aunt, not with me. I have nothing to do with that.
My bad. Speaking of aunt.
God, you're such a mess.
Have you talked to Ronnie lately?
No, but that's been her usual. Like, she'll pop up like every few days. I'm sure she'll pop up when she needs something.
I can't keep up with all this craziness.
How do you think I feel? I'm in the middle of all this shit. I just know I'm sick of talking about Ronnie, so let's talk about something else. How are you?
Time to read this right now. I'm sure it's probably Ronnie and one of them bills or something.
So, you gonna keep hiding your man from everybody?
Hiding what man? I mean, I'm not really hiding Jesus from anybody. I mean, he has to pass a 90-day trial. So nobody got time to be dealing with no kid that's a grown man that I gotta take care of, and he gotta have a cute credit score and what?
Are you trying to be funny?
I mean, no, but you know how these guys are out here these days? Like, I ain't got time for that.
Anyway, so you talked to Deborah. I tried calling her phone, and it must be off.
It's not off. She's ducking me. God. She called me the other day and asked me for some money. I wired her like $100, and then I called her back for the money. She wasn't answering the phone. So next thing I know, the next day on Instagram, her and some big lady going there talking about some new cut, new color. I can't with Deborah.
What?
Yes, like, if you would leave it up to me, she would have been fired a long time ago.
I can't believe she still got a job.
Me neither. All I know is when she comes back, she better have her booth front, and she better have my coins.
Nobody. The conversation looked a little heated to me, but had to be nobody. Don't play with my intelligence.
What are you doing here again?
You know, for someone who doesn't have time to expedite my money, you sure find time to do so many other things.
You will get your money.
When?
Soon.
Look, you've been saying that for the last few weeks, and I'm getting tired.
You know what? I'll write you a check in the morning.
Listen, you're not writing me no check. You're not writing me off, sweetheart.
Well, your mother sure didn't have a problem taking a big check when she left you at our front door.
Now, you know she didn't have any choice.
Oh, she didn't?
It was either leave me, give up custody, or she'd be cut off financially.
Oh, please, Jabril.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to find my mother, and I'm going to give her the life that she really deserves. I mean, that the family owes her that much.
When you find your mother, stay with her.
You know what? I'll have the last laugh.
Is that so?
You know the irony in all of this?
What is it, baby brother? What is it?
You see, you call me this outsider, this bastard son, but the whole time we grew up, I got all the love and attention from our father and your mother. You know what? Bitterness is such an ugly tree.
Shut up!
So, I mean, you're the only one that's so consumed with money, power. You think that's all going to give you respect, though. It's, you're the only one that thinks that, and nobody likes you.
You know what? You're a self-serving son of a bitch.
Look, you've gotten away with all of this from our last name for all your life. But it doesn't take a genius to see that you're just one old miserable bitch. Marriage after marriage, disappointment after disappointment. Shall I go on?
No, you should leave.
That's fine. But you have 24 hours to get my money, okay?
Yeah.
So Jabril came to the salon the other day.
What? And what happened?
I don't know. It was weird, I guess.
I mean, of course it was weird.
I mean, he came and he was talking and I don't know what to believe. I don't know if it was bullshit or he came with sincerity in his eyes.
God, please don't tell me he was rehearsing that same pathetic, sorry-ass apology.
No, that's the thing. It was different. I don't know what to believe.
Well, wait. You know, interesting enough, I was trying to tell you this when, you know, you and Kiko came to my house the other day. But Jabril came to my house last week. And when he came to my house, he was giving me like this whole long sob story about how he messed up and you were the best thing that ever happened to him. And then he went on to say about his family and... Yeah, family. Like, as long as we've known Jabril, he has not said anything about no family.
I'm surprised he brought up family. It was the first time he actually talked to me about his family the other day.
Really?
Yeah.
So, how are you really feeling? Like, do you want to get back with him?
I don't know.
Like, have you had enough?
No, I just don't know what to believe.
Brandon, hello. Step into the light. You're going to get again.
I miss you too. You have no idea. You must be jet lagged.
No, I'm good. Like, I just need like probably a shower, a drink, and you know what else. What's wrong?
Nothing, you know, me just thinking.
You sure?
Yeah, I am, Clint.
I can tell something's wrong with you. Like, what's wrong with you?
Nothing, I just had a hectic day.
The door.
Why are you leaving so soon?
have someone to be important.
Where?
I have to go meet a friend.
Oh my God, I was hoping that we could stay around and catch up on all this fashion around here, girl.
Maybe even another day. I really have to go.
Kiko, wait a minute, girl. What is the rush?
I have to be somewhere.
Oh my God, okay. Well, I was hoping that you could stay, but I guess I'm just alone by myself.
Look at you're fab in the outfit that I picked out for you. Surely you'll find someone to keep you company.
I don't want anybody to keep me company. And around here, the only person I know is my brother. And I don't want his company.
I didn't know you had a brother.
Yes, girl. I have a brother, and he's walking around here somewhere, probably working on his fifth drink.
Well, I'll catch up with you another time.
Okay, I'll talk to you later.
Wait, who invited that broke mess?
Who?
Him right there.
With the blue shirt?
Yes, I know you're buying him a ticket. He ain't got the food for this function.
Girl, that is my baby brother.
Wait.
He is far from broke.
Wait, your brother?
Yes, my brother.
Did I hear you clearly?
Yes, you heard me clearly.
Let me move my weed. Did I hear you loud and clear?
Girl, he is one of the heirs to Davenport Industries, girl.
Tell me this is the joke.
It's
am I being caught?
I wish I was joking. It's not a joke.
That lowlife cheated on my friend Brandon. He practically just took him off the street.
The street?
Yes, the street.
Hold up. Let me process this. You're telling me that my brother, who's a millionaire, was sleeping on the street?
Yes, the street, homeless in a park, baby.
Oh my God. I just can't believe that.
I'm about to go over there and let him have
it. Let me get my purse because I need to hear this.
Oh, well, you need to come over. I'm about to light a fire under that egg.
Let's go.
Damn, babe, are you sure everything was okay? Like, I came straight here from the airport. Straight here.
Clint,
what's up?
I'm good. I'm fine. Everything is good. I'm glad that you came.
So what's wrong with you?
I just been having a lot on my mind. Like, this, us. Like, what am I to you?
What you mean? What type of question is that, babe? Like, you my babe. You my babe. You know that.
I mean, I don't want you to think I don't appreciate you coming over here to see me, but
it's like what? Like, Ashton, you know every time I come over here, it's a risk. You know, every time I come over here through those doors, we're taking a chance. Like,
right.
You know that.
I know, but I need to know if this is real. How do I not know that you're just somebody that comes over here to slide up in me when it's convenient for you or when you're in the mood?
Wait a minute.
I need to know that.
Like, just the other day we was good. Just the other day on the phone, you couldn't wait to see me. We were like, what's going on?
But that's the thing.
What happened?
I miss you a lot. You don't know what's been going on. I really miss you a whole lot, a hell of a lot.
So where's this coming from? Like,
I just need to know if I'm worth you losing your wife to me.
Babe, I told you that already. Like, I thought I proved that to you months ago. Like, yes.
So why the fuck you ain't signed the divorce papers yet?
A different man showed up the other day when I saw him. It's like, I didn't even know who he was.
Child, it's called remorse. He wants you to feel sorry for him. But the bigger question is, would you take him back?
Do you think he honestly loves me?
Honestly, in his sick, decrepit way, I actually think he does love you. And you love him. But you have to know when you had enough. And if you didn't have enough, and you feel like, you know, it's worth salvaging, give it another chance.
I mean, it's hard to just let somebody go. Some days I just really miss him. The other days I'm just reminded of why I stopped talking to his ass.
Well, you gotta weigh the pros and the cons. If the cons outweigh the pros, leave his ass alone. If the pros outweigh the cons, take them back. So, what do you want to do?
All I know is, the way things ended the other day, I know this chapter is nowhere near over.
Child, this chapter is just getting written. Pour me some more of that wine, because I can't.
Let's just finish this bottle, because I don't know what else to do. Cheers to life.
And your next chapter.
Hey,
Brokeback Mountain, you freeloading opportunist?
What are you talking about?
What do you mean? You've been lying to my friend the whole time that you have money?
You're broke. First robbed, now even. What the hell have you been in the past 8 years?
Been a freeloading stunt.
Wait a minute. I'm almost embarrassed to call you my brother. Because I don't want to believe half this stuff.
Don't call me your brother.
I won't.
Thank you.
I won't.
Now, you don't know the story. Mind your business. Okay?
Well, you need to say something and tell him.
I have to tell him nothing until I want to.
Why?
But this is what's not going to happen. You won't open your mouth.
Whatever. I'm going to tell him.
No, you're not.
If you know better, you do better, Jabril. You better tell him.
You better leave that alone.
No, that's my money right there.
Well, be the gopher and the fool for her.
I can't deal with this. Bye.
Goodbye.
It's not that easy. Like, you don't know who I'm dealing with. You don't, like, she'll fuck around and make your life a living hell.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, fine.
All right. Babe, can you just be a little bit more patient? Like, chill out.
A little bit more patient?
Yeah.
Hey, get the fuck out of here, it's been a fucking year.
Come on.
You don't think I've been patient enough?
Babe.
Over a fucking year, just.
Yeah, chill out. Wait, yo, hold up. I love you and everything. Don't chill. Like, don't ever put your fucking hands on me again like that. You understand? You understand?
Look, Clint, like, tell me this.
Breathe easy. What?
How much do you love me?
What do you mean? Like,
because I love you.
I love you too. Like, I haven't proved it to you already, man. Come on now. Come on. Look, I'm trying. Just give me a little bit more time. Hey.
Stop.
Hey, come on. Come here,
stop.
Come here. You know how much I love you, right? Like, you feel that. You feel that.
I feel what?
Me.
Dear Mason, if you're reading this, I have decided to leave town. I just couldn't go through with the meeting with Victor. With not having his money, it would have just ended badly. Please don't hate me for leaving without saying goodbye. But I couldn't break the news to you in person. I have always done right by the people I love. That is why I'm doing the hardest thing I have ever done in life. Once everything dies down, I will contact you. But until then, I'm tying the shop over to you. In the drawer, you'll find a deed already signed in your name. Mason, I trust that you will do a better job than I ever could. Thank you for everything. Love always, Ronnie.
Wait. Hold up. Who the fuck is this bitch? You really think
this is Derek?
Oh, this is the infamous Derek.
Yes, it is.
Oh, no. Hold the fuck up. Wait, how are you gonna come to the salon and ask for Brandon's forgiveness? And you brought this Tatiana here?
That's me and Brandon.
I know, right?
So what? This is my friend. So I'm gonna tell him everything right here. What's going on, honey? Oh, I am. Okay, I am. Right, bye. Right,
turn off the lights.
What? Nah, don't turn off the lights. I want to see. I want to see everything.
What do you want to see?
Come here.
Brandon, open up. It's me.
It's late. What are you doing here?
I need to talk to you. It's important.
This can't wait till the morning?
No, it can't.
Don't make this a habit. You say you're gonna give me some space.
I am. But I need to tell you this now.
Have you been drinking?
No. Yes, but I'm not.
Oh, where are you coming from?
That's not important. What is important is me finally coming clean about everything.
Okay. You've been drinking. You came to apologize once. You can leave now. Truth. You flat out abused me.
Come on, that's a lie. I never needed your financial assistance.
Whatever, Jabril.
Come on, I can prove it.
How?
By telling you my real name.
Yeah, you've been drinking. I know your damn name.
No, you met me as Jabril Anderson. But my full name is Jabril Anderson Davenport.
Whatever, you've been drinking, you talking crazy.
No, look, Brandon, for the last time, listen, I'm not drunk. Look, take a minute, look at me and let this sink in.
This is weird. It's not making no sense. Your name is Jabril Anderson.
Look. Anderson was my mom's name. And she abandoned me when I was just like a little child. And so my father had to raise me. And that's where I got the last name, Davenport.
But you told me your parents were dead.
And I know what I told you, but in my eyes, they were dead.
So now they're alive. This must be some sick joke.
No,
are you enjoying this?
No, I'm just tired of hurting you.
I got you. Chill out. I got this.
You want this forever?
What?
Do you want this forever?
Hell yeah, nigga.
Do you know what you gotta do?
Get up. Toot that shit up. Put that shit up. Do I got a dummy written on my forehead?
Nope, Brandon, you're not dumb. Look, I take the blame for all of this. I created this mess.
Yeah, you're right.
Look, I know I lied to you about a few things, but it was all for a good reason.
And what you mean by that?
Look, I withheld who I was because I was ashamed of my family and where I came from. And I didn't want my life or my happiness defined or quantified by my family's last name.
But even if you say it's all true, how do I know that this Jabril Anderson person exists?
I'm standing right here in front of you.
I mean, if what you're saying is true, then why would you play the bro card?
Look, I didn't have any money. I still don't. I gave all of that up the moment my father found out I was gay. No son of his was going to be homosexual, so I left.
Excuse me if it's hard for me to believe all this.
Look, you don't believe me here. Look it up for yourself.
I don't want your phone. I want my old life back. You're taking everything from me.
Come on, this is the God's honest truth here.
We've been together for 3 years. Somewhere in that time, you could have at least told me and been honest.
Look, it was so many times.
Nope, I forgot who I'm talking to.
Look, it was so many times that I just wanted to tell you the truth. But as time went on, I had no choice but to keep up the same charade.
So you build a whole new persona?
Yes.
So which is the real you?
This is the real me.
I sure know how to pick them.
Look, by the time I met you, I was so used to telling people the lie, it was just natural. I mean, Brandon, when I first met you, I didn't even think we was gonna go past a month. And you have no idea how bad this hurt me inside.
Obviously not bad enough. I mean, just when I try to get over you and the craziness from the past, here you go, ruining the little bit of happiness I have left.
No more lies. I promise you this.
Man, go dog hit someone else's doorstep.
So now you're kicking me out?
Yes. I wish I never met you.
I know you don't mean that.
Yes, I do. I can't believe I wasted 3 years on a man who can't even be honest. Now get out.
No.
You're not even wanted around here.
Look, you can at least look me in my eye if you're kicking me out.
Look, if you don't get out, I'm gonna call the police and then a night in jail maybe will help.
You do that?
Yes, I can't stand you.
That's a lie.
You're right, I hate you.
Excuse you?
Listen, get out of my face. Are you crazy?
Yes. You tell me you don't love me and I'll leave and never come back.
Get out of my face.
Tell me.
Oh, shit. Welcome home, babe.
Damn, boy.
But you know now, we're locked for life.
What up?
But you know what you gotta do.
What?
Clint, we talked about this. You gotta sign the papers.
Oh, man, we'll get it done.
You promise me?
Yeah.
Do you love me?
You know I love you, baby.
Okay.
Why not? I miss you so much.